Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing parabola and this is video lecture number 11. I hope you have already watched part 1 through part 10 before watching part 11. And we are now discussing the characteristics of parabola. First of all, we are going to discuss one point, which is one characteristics, say first characteristics. If T1 and T2 are the focal code, are the end point of focal code of parabola. Then T1, T2 is equal to minus 1. This is one property which I have to discuss this. T1 and T2 are the end point of focal code of parabola. Suppose this is a parabola and these are the P and Q are end points, which is T1 and T2. T1 and T2 means the point on parabola would be 8T1 square, 2A T1, right? This is what? And y square is equal to 4ax is parabola. Because this is a focal point, so this point can have coordinate a comma 0. This is y axis, x axis, and x axis. Like this. This is origin. So 0, 0, O is the point. Now, P and Q are end point of focal code of parabola. So, there is a relation between this T1 and T2 would be minus 1. How it is that? Let me prove this. First of all, I would like to prove it that equation of line joining from P and S. Using two-point form, we can write a proof of this. This is not a question, this is a statement, we can prove it and we can use it. Equation of line PS, using two-point form is y minus y1, that is 0, is equal to y2 minus y1, 2at1 minus 0 upon x2 minus x1, at1 square minus a, x minus x1, x1 is a. This is using 2.4. Now I can write here y is equal to 2at1 upon a t1 square minus 1, x minus a. Right? This is the equation of PS. Since this line also passes through Q, so it will satisfy the equation of coordinate of Q as well. Since this passes through P2, and therefore it satisfies the equation. The coordinate at2 square comma 2at2. So what will happen by using the same? We will have y is equal to 2at2 and 2at1 divided by at1 square minus 1, x minus a, and x is what? at2 square minus a. 2a cancels out. This implies now left it is t1 upon a t1 square minus 1. We can write this. This will multiply this side. So a t1 square minus 1 is equal to t1 left from here, and a I can take common, t2 square minus 1. a again cancels out. Now this will be T2 T1 square minus T2 is equal to T1 T2 square minus T1. Now if I would take T2 T1 square, this will come this side, T1 T2 square is equal to T2 minus T1. Now if I would take common from here, T2 T1, if I would take common, then what is left here? T1 minus T2. And that is, if I am taking minus common, then this will be T1 minus T2. T1 minus T2 will cancel out, because since T1 is not equal to T2, as T1 and T2 are two different points. So T1 minus T2 and T1 minus T2 can be cancelled, and what is left? Therefore, this implies T1, T2 left one side, another side left minus 1. So this is the characteristics which I wanted to tell you, that T1, T2 is equal to minus 1. And this is the characteristics. I hope you got it. T1, T2 are the end points of focal chord of parabola. Then T1, T2 is equal to minus 1. You need to remember and use it, that if T1 is one end of focal chord of parabola, then T2 must be equal to what? Minus 1 by T1. That can be also defined, and then T1, T2 is equal to minus 1. So you can use this. Now let me write the second property. If normal at any point T1 on the parabola y square is equal to 4x meets at point T2, then T2 is equal to minus T1 minus 2 by T1. This is the characteristics what you need to understand, and that we have to verify. Equation of normal at any point T1 on parabola. You remember this? This is a parabola. Any point T1. T1 is AT1 square comma 2AT1. Normal at this point is what? This is the normal, because this is a tangent, and therefore normal is this. And this parabola normal meets at any other point T2. That is AT2 square comma 2AT2. Normal at, this is a tangent, you know, and tangent at any point P meets the normal, this, and normal at this point will meet the parabola again at T2, then T1, T2 is equal to, this is the relation. What you have to find out? So we know profit, we know the equation of normal, at any point T, T1 to the parabola y square is equal to 4x. Do you remember that? What is the equation of normal? I discussed in last class and told you to remember this. Please go ahead. What is that? Tx plus y minus 2at minus at cube. This was the equation. Tx plus y minus 2at minus at cube. This was the equation and of the parabola. Since at point T1, so instead of T, there would be T1 and T1. Right? This is the equation of normal. So equation of normal at parabola this edge, this. Since it also passes through T2, so it will satisfy the equation. Since it also passes through T2, therefore satisfy the equation. Satisfy the equation means in place of x, I should write x coordinate, right? So x coordinate is what? AT2 square plus 2AT2 minus 2AT1 minus AT1 is cube is equal to 0, right? So 2AT1 minus AT1 cube is equal to 0. This is what the equation. I have satisfied this. So here what will happen? If I take 2A common from this, 2A, A can be cancelled throughout, and now I can take care that 2A, let me write this side. If I take A common, so 2 common, then this will be T2 minus T1. A cancels throughout. Now T1 T2 square minus A T1 cube. So I can take T1 common, and that will be T2 square from here and T1 square from there will be left out. Now we can write here 2 T2 minus T1 plus T1 T2 minus T1 into T2 plus T1 is equal to 0. T2 minus T1 I can take common. So now I can take T2 minus T1 as common. So if I would take or cancel T2 minus T1 both the sides, I can take T2 minus T1 common, then it will be twice plus T1 into T1 plus T2 is equal to 0. This will come. Since T2 is still not equal to T1, then that cannot be equal to 0. Therefore, T2 minus T1 cannot be equal to 0. So what will be equal to 0? 2 plus T1 into T1 plus T2 would be equal to 0. That will be T1 plus T2 into T1 is equal to minus 2. And therefore T1 plus T2 is equal to minus 2 by T1. And this implies T2 is equal to minus T1 minus 2 by T1. And this is the equation, this is the condition what we need to verify. So you must remember this. This will be very, very useful conditions. And that condition will be used in most of the cases. And question can be asked directly or even on the basis of properties, this can be asked easily, right? So I hope you got this point, okay? Now, let me write some other ones. Third property, and third property is, should I write this? I hope you got this. Let me explain once again. If normal at any point T1 on the parabola y square equal to 4s meets at point T2 again, then T2 is equal to minus T1 minus 2 by T1. Meets at point T2 again is here, then T2 is equal to this. Equation of normal I have drawn here, written here, and because it passes through T2, so T2 will satisfy and the given condition can be obtained by using this fact. Right? Okay. Now, let me write the third one. Third characteristic says, if normal at T1 and T2, normals drawn at T1 and T2 admits at any point T on the parabola, then P1, P2 is equal to 2. This is the condition. P1, P2 is equal to 2. Now, again, I can use this without drawing. There are two normals and that can possible. They meet the parabola again. Normal at any point can meet the parabola again. So, it can be, this is the relation. So, how to find this? Proof. Using the previous one. If normal drawn at P1 meets the parabola again at T, then T must be equal to minus T1 minus 2 by T1 using the previous property. Also, it is given that normal drawn at T2 meets the parabola again at T, then T must be equal to minus T2 minus 2 by T2. Right? According to the given characteristics. Now, using first and second. Both have LHS are same, so RHS must be same. Minus T1 minus 2 by T1 is equal to minus T2 minus 2 by T2. And therefore, we can write T2 minus T1. T2 will come this side, it will be positive. And 2 by T1 come this side, it will be positive. 2 by T1 minus 2 by T2. Right? Now, this will come here. T2 minus T1 is equal to 2, I can take common. And this will be T2 minus T1 upon T1, T2. T2 minus T1, T2 minus T1 can be cancels out because T1 and T2 are two different points. Since T1 and T2 are two different points. Since T1 is not equal to T2. These are two different points. Therefore, this will multiply this side. What will come? T1, T2. And what is left here? 2. This is the proof of this assumptions, proof of this axiom, and you can use it directly whenever there is a question and you want to find the solution of the question. So in that case, you will be able to use this. Three important characteristics we have learned today, and these three important characteristics will be very, very important for solving the questions in competitive examination, and you will be able to analyze them, how to solve the questions. And we will discuss in upcoming videos use of all this and how to solve questions related to this. One more important characteristics I would like to discuss here, that tangent at any point T1 and normal at any point T1 can have the relations as well. Some other ideas are also there in which we can deal with. But before that, discussing anything else, I would like to discuss one more characteristics related to point. Any point, position of point, heading can be drawn like position of point x1, y1 with respect to parabola y square is equal to 4x. We want to find out the position of point with respect to parabola coordinate of this point in this equation. Always, whatever the type of equation may be, it is x square equal to 4ay or y square equal to 4x or any other form of the equation, put the coordinates there. That is, after putting this, what will happen? Y1 square minus 4ax1. If it is equal to 0, it means parabola, this point satisfies the equation of parabola. And since it satisfies the equation of parabola, then this will lie on the parabola. Then points lie on the parabola. Point x1, y1 lies on parabola. On parabola, y square is equal to 4ax. If y1 square minus 4ax1 is less than 0, then point x1, y1 lies inside of the parabola. Of the parabola. When somewhere, like if this is a parabola, then point lies either here or here or here, somewhere inside. In first case, point lies here on parabola, anywhere on this boundary. But in second case, point lie inside the parabola. Y square is equal to 4x. Here, 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 here. Means this region, they lie inside of the parabola. And the third case is, if y square minus 4a, y1 square minus 4ax1 is greater than 0, then point x1, y1 lie outside of the parabola. Outside of the parabola means this point neither lies inside of the parabola nor on the parabola but lies outside of the parabola somewhere like this. So these are the characteristics, and this will be the three different cases which we need to consider, and on the basis of that we can find whether the point lies inside the parabola, outside of the parabola or on the parabola. So, one question in support of that. Find the position of point 2, 3 with respect to parabola 3y square is equal to 8x. If I put the value 3y square, y coordinate is what? 3. So 3 into 3 square minus 8 into 2 is this. What is that? 9 into 3, 27 minus 16 is greater than 0. Right? And therefore, the point lies outside of the parabola. The point 2, 3 lies outside of the parabola. The parabola. Since this is a positive, so point lies outside. If it is less than 0, that is negative, then point lies inside of the parabola. And if it is equal to 0, then point lies on the parabola. I hope you got it. So position of any point can be obtained by using this fact. Let us consider one more example, just to explain this idea. Any point minus 3 and 5, the point, find the position of point minus 3 and 5 with respect to parabola, bola 3x square minus 5y plus 7 is equal to 0. So I have just put this point in this one. In place of x, if I will put here, what is this? Minus 3. So 3 square. In place of y, we will put 5, and this is 7. Now 3 3 is 9, 9 3 is 27, 27 plus 7 is 34 minus 25 is greater than 0. This point also lies outside of the parabola. If I would have written here minus sign, then what will happen in that case? Say minus, because we did last question for outside. So how here is 27, 25 minus 7 is 32. This is 27, this is 32. Then in that case it would be less than 0. So this point lies inside of this parabola, and if it was positive, then this point lies outside of the parabola. This is 27 minus 25 minus 7, which is less than 0, and therefore the point minus 3, 5 lies outside of the parabola, inside of the parabola. This point lies inside of the parabola. So it is not a difficult thing. I hope you got it. How to deal with such certain situations and what is the position of any point with respect to parabola, and you will be able to analyze it easily. And on the basis of that, you can find this. Some more characteristics of parabola we will discuss in the next video lecture, and thereafter we will discuss some questions as well. So please keep watching and be in touch. If there is any problem, you are not able to understand at any point during the solution or verification or proof of any statement, then please watch it again. And if there is again problem persist, write us to our Gmail ID, arvindsinghacademy@gmail.com. We will surely respond to you as soon as possible. Thank you. Thank you very much for watching. God bless.